Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to worship at Meadowbrook Congregational Church. I'm Pastor Joel Boyd, and I'm blessed to serve this congregation and its members and friends. A special welcome to any visitors joining us today, be you in person or joining us online. We're glad to have you with us today. You're invited to participate in any of the ministries that we have at our church. You can learn more about that in our weekly messenger email, which you could sign up for, or you can learn more on our Facebook page or our website. Well, today, friends, we live into a special liturgy called Thanks Be to God, a harvest hymn festival, where we sing praises to God in a music and scripture-filled service of thanksgiving. And in a moment, I'll hand it over to our director of music, Danny Reeves, who'll share a bit more about today's service with you. Last week, we celebrated Consecration Sunday when pledges for the 2024 church year were blessed and dedicated to the service of God's work in this church. As you well know, these gifts support the ongoing ministries of our congregation as we live out the love of Jesus in our local church and community. If you have yet to submit an estimate of giving card, you still have options to do so. You may bring your card with you to worship and place it in the offering plate when it is passed. You may also choose to mail it to the church address, or you could submit your pledge electronically using the link in the weekly messenger email. Well, many thanks to all who came out in support of our open mic night this last Friday. We had a great time, a great attendance, lots of fun, food, and fellowship was had by all. And special thanks to Steve Keller for coordinating all of the music in the event, and to the members of our band. We had a big band this year. Not a big band is the style of music, an actual large band. So we had Floyd Rayon, Tim Paul, Mark Dukes, Danny Reeves, Scott Hokett as our band, and we also had Heidi Boyd, Stephanie Kennick, and Yvonne Wilson as our backup singers as well. And thank you to all who performed throughout the evening as well. At this time, I invite Colleen Foster to come forward to share with us an announcement about an upcoming parade we have.
Good morning. So just a reminder, this Friday night, it seems so early, but this Friday night is the Northville Lighted Parade. It starts at 6 o'clock, we get together at 6 o'clock in the Northville Library parking lot. And so if you would like to walk with us, carry a banner, hand out candy, hand out cards for the cookie walk, we would love to have you. And also, if any of you feel the urge or whatever, tomorrow Tina Goodrell and I are going to spruce up the float. The guys are coming at 10:30 or 11 to make sure the generator works, the lights work, the tires are filled, and then Tina and I are going to try and spruce it up. So if anyone else wants to come on over and help us decorate it, that would be great. So thanks.
Thank you, Colleen. Well, everyone's welcome to join us for our annual Pilgrim Potluck next Sunday, Harvest Sunday, on November 19th. Immediately following our worship service, you're invited to bring a main dish, a side dish, dessert, bread, or rolls to pass, and you can see the link in the messenger email to sign up. Save the date and plan to join us for God with All of Us, our new intergenerational Christmas pageant, which will be held during the 4 p.m. family service on Christmas Eve. You, your family, friends, and your neighbors of all ages can be part of the story, either as individuals or as a group. Maybe you'll be a family of shepherds or angels. So you can see the link in the messenger to sign up, or let me know if you want to learn a little bit more about it. Well, at this time, I invite our director of music, Danny Reeves, to share with us a few words about today's special service. Danny.
Good morning. Today's service is focused on congregational song. Singing will be our way of bringing our intentions to God today. The hymns, scriptures, and poems are centered around thankfulness and praise, but also about God's steadfast love for us and for nature. That as Christians, we show our faith through work and prayer, and that God's giving has no end. You guys are all invited to sing every hymn with the first and the last standing in body or spirit. Thank you.
Friends, may the peace of the Lord be with you. Let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace. Well, friends, let us now take a time to prepare our hearts and our minds for the worship of our Lord. Rise in body or spirit and join in our call to worship. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, call on his name, make known his deeds among the peoples, sing to him, sing praises to him, tell of all his wonderful works. me in the opening prayer, followed by the Lord's Prayer. Eternal God, high and lifted up, and yet within us all, we come, and having spent too much time with our heads down, now have the need to be lifted up. Let us be lifted to a spirit of adoration, that we may see in life all that is beautiful and good, excellent and of good report, that we may not be blind to your love of life. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
You may be seated.
Good morning. Hey, and it works. All right. We have a good-sized group today. So, today in Sunday school, we are going to learn about another prophet. We've been learning about Samuel. We're going to learn about somebody else today. And a few weeks ago, I said a prophet was a spokesperson for God. You got it. So in today's story, God tells this prophet to go to this town and tell all the people about God. So if you were the prophet, what would you do? Tell all the people? You know what he does? He runs away and hides from God. How do you think that's going to go? That's weird. It's probably going to go bad. Well, if I tell you his name, you might know how it kind of how it goes. You think you know? It's Jonah. Yes. Yeah. All right. So you're probably a little familiar with that story. Okay. Benj is going to teach today. He goes on a boat. He falls in the water and gets swallowed by a whale. We're done. There we go. All right. Well, we'll go see if we learn a little bit more about that story. But first, we're going to pray. You ready? Dear God, we thank you that you are always with us, loving us and caring for us. Bless us today and all our days as we journey together. In Jesus' name, amen.
If you heed these ordinances, by diligently observing them, the Lord your God will maintain with you the covenant loyalty that he swore to your ancestors. He will love you, bless you, and multiply you. He will bless the fruit of your womb and the fruit of your ground, your grain and your wine and your oil, the increase of your cattle and the issue of your flock in the land that he swore to your ancestors to give you.
And why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the fields, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? Therefore, do not worry, saying, what will we eat? Or what will we drink? Or what will we wear? For it is the Gentiles who strive for all these things. And indeed, your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But strive first for the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well.
that there may be no dissension within the body. The members may have the same care for one another. If one member suffers, all suffer together with it. If one member is honored, all rejoice together with it.
Because we look not at what can be seen, but at what cannot be seen. For what can be seen is temporary, but what cannot be seen is eternal.
But be doers of the word, and not merely hearers who deceive themselves. For if any are hearers of the word and not doers, they are like those who look at themselves in a mirror. For they look at themselves and, on going away, immediately forget what they were like. But those who look into the perfect law, the law of liberty, and persevere, being not bearers, hearers who forget, but doers who act. They will be blessed in their doing. They are like trees planted by streams of water, which yield their fruit in its season, and their leaves do not wither. In all that they do, they prosper.
For the Lord watches over the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked will perish.
Commit your work to the Lord.
The human mind may devise many plans, but it is the purpose of the Lord that will be established.
What gain have the workers from their toil? I have seen the business that God has given to everyone to be busy with. He has made everything suitable for its time. Moreover, he has put a sense of past and future into their minds, yet they cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. I know that there is nothing better for them than to be happy and enjoy themselves as long as they live. Moreover, it is God's gift that all should eat and drink and take pleasure in all their toil. I know that whatever God does endures forever. Nothing can be added to it, nor anything taken from it. God has done this so that all should stand in awe before him. That which is already has been. That which is to be already is. And God seeks out what has gone by.
Friends, the offering for the work of this church will now be received. If you have chosen to give electronically, you're invited to take one of the yellow cards in the pew and place it in the basket when it is passed. Let us pray. God of all love, Lord, you bless us to be your people. We ask that you bless these, our gifts, that they may continue to inspire our hearts to be your church in the world. Fill us with your spirit that we may share the love of Jesus with all we meet. It is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. She walks in beauty like the night, of cloudless climes and starry skies, and all that's best of dark and bright meet in her aspect and her eyes, thus mellowed to that tender light which heaven to gaudy days denied. One shade the more, one ray the less, had half impaired the nameless grace which waves in every raven trees or softly lingers o'er her face. Where thoughts serenely sweet express how pure, how dear their dwelling place. And on that cheek and o'er that brow, so soft, so calm, yet eloquent, the smile that wins, the tints that glow, but tell of days in goodness spent, a mind at peace with all below, a heart whose love is innocent.
When you are old and gray and full of sleep and nodding by the fire, take down this book and slowly read and dream of the soft look your eyes had once and of their shadows deep. How many loved your moments of glad grace and loved your beauty with love, false or true. But one man loved the pilgrim soul in you and loved the sorrows of your changing face. Bending down beside the glowing bars, murmur a little sadly how love fled and paced upon the mountains overhead and hid his face among a crowd of stars.
Thank you.
Let us now take a time to raise those prayers deep inside our hearts to the Lord as we pray now in a time of silence. God, who made all of us for good, Lord, be with us in our joy and with us in our suffering. Hear the prayers of your people and bless us again to be your people in the world. Lord, we continue to pray for all those impacted by the Israel-Gaza war. We pray for all impacted by the shooting recently in Lewiston, Maine. Lord, we pray for the family of Sarah DePasquale, Jody and David Scheller's daughter, as she passed to her eternal rest in you on October 29th, following a several years-long battle with cancer. Lord, we also raise Dave and Jody to you, knowing that this last week they celebrated their anniversary. Lord, we give you thanks and praise for all of our veterans and express our gratitude to all veterans and to their families for their service. Lord, we pray for Reverend Chris Kurtz and all the members and friends of the First Congregational Church of Royal Oak, as Reverend Kurtz will soon have an installation service this afternoon. We continue to pray for Bill Ahrens as he recovers from a knee replacement surgery on November 2nd. We pray for Molly Stephenson, Jess Hokett Stephenson's daughter, and Patty and Charlie Hokett's granddaughter, as Molly has recently lost more hearing and will soon undergo a surgery. Lord, we continue to pray for the family of Tom Voital, Barb Campbell's son-in-law, as he passed to his eternal rest in you on October 23rd. We pray for Lois Boyd, my mom, as she continues her recovery from a recent eye procedure. We pray for Joyce Paxton as she recovers from a hip surgery on October 16th. We continue to pray for Annette Reuter Andrews, Dave and Gail McKillop's daughter-in-law, as she makes her recovery from a recent bone marrow transplant. We pray for all your people impacted by the war in Ukraine, Lord, and that the war there may come to an end. We give you thanks for and wish happy birthdays to John Webster, to Lois Winters, and to Mary Crockett, all who celebrate this coming week with Mary turning 100. Lord, we wish a special first anniversary to Joshua and Sherilyn Foster Tucker, who celebrate 1 year today. We raise all these prayers to you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Above all, maintain constant love for one another, for love covers a multitude of sins. Be hospitable to one another without complaining.
Like good stewards of the manifold grace of God, serve one another with whatever gift each of you has received.
Whoever speaks must do so as one speaking the very words of God. Whoever serves must do so with the strength that God supplies, so that God may be glorified in all things through Jesus Christ.
To him belong the glory and the power forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Reading from Proverbs 27, verse 19. As water reflects the face, so one's life reflects the heart. The young girl always stopped by the pond on her way home from school. Late into the fall, the leaves had by now all changed color, and many were scattered on the ground or stacked on the corner in yard bags. When she got to the pond, she thought it might soon begin to freeze over, which started to happen every year about this time. But as she walked up close, she could still see the slight ripples of the water, sun rays bouncing off and back into the sky. A pair of ducks noisily dunked their heads in the water. A lone fisherman sat across the other side of the pond, his dog seated at his side. Placing her backpack down, the girl approached the water's edge. Finding a few stones, she cast them out, skimming the top of the rippling water. Her pocket buzzes. A text from Mom. On your way? Yep, she replies. Okay. Don't forget basketball practice tonight. Love you. Heart emoji. She walked closer to the water, leaned over, and looked down into it. At first, seeing the rocks, dirt, and tiny fish skittering around. But soon her gaze spread more broadly, and she came to see her own reflection shining back from the water. She could make out her brown hair, see her jacket, and if she squinted, she could even make out her braces. Yep, that was her. At least what she looked like on the outside. But what did it show about everything else? What was inside her? Her thoughts, dreams, and fears. She bent over to look more closely, trying to see if she could catch a glimmer of who she really was, and maybe even what other people saw in her. Just then, the fisherman yelped and jumped out of his chair, his dog barking, and he feverishly went to work, reeling in the fish that was on the end of the line. The girl suddenly remembered the text from her mom and thought she'd better get going, or she'd be late for her practice. Looking at her, you wouldn't think much of a future basketball career, but she loved the game, was good at it, and wanted to make sure the coach saw all that on the court. The fisherman proudly held up his catch across the pond to her, and the girl waved as she picked up her backpack, heading out on her way. How many of us have thought similar things about how we are known? When that girl looked down into the water to see the reflection of her own face, she wondered how she could see what's inside of her and how others would know who she really was. No doubt many of us have asked ourselves the same question about our identity and about how we're known by those around us. When the busy young woman pulls aside her cart full at the grocery store to let an elderly man go ahead of her with his loaf of bread and medicine. When the boss lays off long-serving members of the team during a pandemic, all while taking an increase himself. When a church group reaches out to the food insecure in their community to provide healthy and accessible food options. When the bully is finally rendered powerless because somebody got the gumption to stand up to him. When people continue to support their local restaurants and thus jobs and families in a post-pandemic time. And when people thank a first responder for all they do, not only during times of great challenge or times of heightened gratitude like Thanksgiving, but even when they see that cold police officer assisting in a road project in the wintertime. Friends, don't these actions speak to what is in our hearts? Don't they say a great deal about us and the kind of people we are, who we are? You could add many examples from this list from your own experience. Indeed, it could be suggested that every single act of our lives represents or reflects who we are. That can be a scary thought. Yet if we're to take the gospel seriously, we witness that how Jesus is Lord over our entire lives. That's what he says. Not just a couple hours on a Sunday, or for various meetings and activities throughout a week. Jesus is Lord of Monday through Saturday, just as much as he's Lord of Sunday. What would happen if we held this proverbial wisdom of the sages in mind each day, with each thought, each action? How might we then be continually showing our hearts? Note, not shown, not will show, not show, but showing. Something which is ongoing. How do our actions reflect us as showing our hearts? We may rest, take time for prayer and self-care, but we're not a stagnant people. We're people of God, and we're on the move. Each one of us will wake up and do things, say things in the world. We'll do this for the rest of our lives. And the wise sage in Proverbs shows us that our actions will most certainly communicate our values. The true feelings of our innermost hearts will impress themselves on everyone around us. Like it or not, what we do, who we are in the world, it all matters. It all has an impact. If we show up regularly and are dedicated, all will know. And if we fall away and become disengaged, people can see that too. This is why our witness to Jesus Christ must be in the forefront of our hearts and our minds. This is why we worship every week, reminding ourselves that we're God's children, that we belong to God, that it is Jesus who has won our hearts forever. While we may sit around somewhat different-looking settings this coming Thanksgiving, be they lavish or spare, we may know that it's not about all the things or the stuff we have, or about excelling over other people, or celebrating only past victories. Our gratitude is not about what we get. It's about who we're called to be. It's about who we are. So may we give thanks to God for the gift of Jesus and our faith in him. And may the Spirit fill our hearts and minds with not only the wisdom, knowledge, and call to follow Jesus, but also the guts to do so every day, no matter what happens. Friends, may we live each day actively showing our hearts as we love and serve in Jesus' name each moment. Amen. Lord, lift us up to a spirit of living thanksgiving. Quicken our sense of gratitude for your lavish heart, your gentle hand, your strong word, your quiet grace. Recall to us the homes that have nourished us, the friends who bless us, the social securities which we enjoy, the great books, great music, and great art that have inspired our own creativity. Make real to us anew him who loved us and gave himself for us, even Jesus Christ, for whom our thanksgiving is never ending. Amen.